Can you use NVivo to conduct your literature review? Yes. As you can see here, I have all my themes and codes. I was able to generate topics based on the article that I've uploaded into NVivo. And as you can see here, there's a list of articles I uploaded. When you go to quotes, you have all the quotes based on the questions I want to find answers to or the topics I want to look into based on the articles that I have, right? So yes, it's possible that you can use NVivo to do your literature review. And so I'm going to show you step-by-step how to conduct your literature review using NVivo. First of all, as you can see here, I have a list of articles I've identified that talks about ChatGPT. Let's assume that you are doing a research, you want to know more about what is happening concerning ChatGPT, the meaning, the features, the limitations, and all the things that you want to know about ChatGPT. So what I did was identify academic articles about ChatGPT. As you can see, these are the articles that I got. I can open one of them for you to see how it looks like. So this is one of the articles that talks about the role of artificial intelligence in enhancing academic performance. So I was able to identify articles and label all the files based on the authors. So imagine that you have already gotten your articles. What is the next step? Next step is to create an Excel spreadsheet that has all the lists of the article. Make sure that the names that you have given to the files or the articles are the same name in terms of the space. Everything should be the same. The reason why you are creating this Excel spreadsheet is to put all the characteristics, the main characteristics of the articles here, so that you can upload it into NVivo as having background information about the article in terms of the year published, the title, and also the type of article. It's quite similar to having demographic information. So in this case, you are having a list of articles and their respective characteristics that are important for you to look into after you have reviewed all the articles, right? You see that the first row will be the column titles, the authors, year of publication, title of the article, and also the type of an article. And you can also put information about maybe the type of study or the research approach that was used in case you want to bring that information into NVivo. So when you enter everything in Excel spreadsheet, you save that information and then close it. Now what you have to do is to go to NVivo and provide the name of the project. So I can say standing for literature review project. I click on next and then I click here yes and click on create project. Now you have your project open, you go to import. We are going to import all the articles. So you click on import, click on file, and then look for the article. Let me look for the article. I select the ones that I need, and then when you finish, click on open and go to import. I've imported all the articles. So now what you have to do is create containers or cases for each of them. Why do you have to create cases? So you want to bring their characteristics, the information that was in the Excel spreadsheet. The system cannot connect the characteristics to this file that I've brought here without creating cases for each file. So a case will help you to glue the articles to their characteristics. So this one, you can select the first one, press on shift and click on the last one so that you select everything and right click and go to create. And then create as you click on that and then you click on okay. So now you have created cases for them. Don't worry about the references. It's not really important. When you create cases, these numbers come here. Don't focus too much upon that for now. What you have to do is to see whether the cases have been created. So you go to cases and then you see that I've created cases for each participant. But we don't have the characteristics yet, the information that was in Excel. So what do you have to do? You go to import classifications, import classification sheet, and you look for that information. You can see here the literature characteristics. So you click on next, and then you make sure you choose case classification, and then click on next, and you click on name as, you go to select, and you don't do anything here. You just make sure that you check name as names. You check as names, and then you go to next, and then you click on finish. Alter here is like a folder that has all the characteristics. And then you want to check whether all the articles, the cases, have been connected to the characteristics in this folder. When I select the first one, just press on shift and select the last one and click on what I've selected and go to classification, I can see that everything has been assigned to their characteristics. So we are good to go. But the next process is to start the coding process, right? But in order to start the review or the coding process, you press on code, you can have some topics that will help you to go through the data. This is where you have to learn about the content analysis. So the content analysis is all about generating codes first or generating initial topics and going through the data and identify information that are significant and then drop them into those topics. You can also apply thematic analysis where you have specific questions that you want to answer. In my case, I have about 6 questions that I want to answer based on the transcript that I have. As you can see, I have some questions that I want to find answers to. So the first question is, what is the role of ChatGPT? The second one will be, what are the functions of ChatGPT? The third one, the meaning of ChatGPT. The fourth one, limitation of ChatGPT. So in this case, I have specific questions that I want to answer as I go through the data. You can look at this as thematic analysis because you have created questions and I want to go through the data, identify significant information, and then generate codes to address these questions. So as you can see, I've generated codes to address the questions. Another option that you can do is that you can generate codes and themes or topics, and then go to your articles and find out, identify information that are significant and then connect to those topics that you have. So there's flexibility here. You just have to choose a strategy that you think will help you at the end of the day to get information about the topics so that you can write about them. Especially if you don't have idea about the specific topics that you want to focus on in terms of writing about your literature review, it makes sense to start with questions. You can brainstorm questions. You can say, based on these articles or based on what I want to focus on, I want answers to these questions. And you list all these questions and go through the literature, identify information that can help you to address those questions. And then you'll be able to generate topics that you can present about. One thing that you can do here is that the same skill about coding your data, we can create containers for the questions, right? So we click on code here, we right click here, you go to new code, and this one is question about the role of ChatGPT, and click on aggregate coding from children, and then you go to next one, right click, new code, and then I bring the next question about the functions, and you bring it here, and aggregate. So you bring all the questions here, and then what you have to do is you click on files, open one of the files and click here, code, so that all the questions will be here, and go to the data. If you see something here that is significant, you select. And then what you can do is that you can go to where this one is addressing. Maybe it's addressing the first research question about the role, right? Let's assume that one of the role here is, we right click here and you develop a label that represent this information. So let's assume that one of the roles is like, it speeds up the research process. So you can bring that information here as a code and then check aggregate coding from children and click on okay. It's an empty container. Then you can drag and drop the information here. So that's how you're gonna do. You go through, identify information that's significant, develop a code and bring it under the respective research question. That's the easier way that you can do. As you can see here, this is what I've done. I was able to go through all the articles and identify significant information. When you finish the first article, right, assuming that we have the codes here, you close the article and go to files and open the second article and then go back to codes so that you show codes and then go through the article and identify information that are significant and drop it into the container. if you realize that you identify something that has nothing to do with any of the code that you have created, you can create a new code. As you can also see here, I created a container for my conceptual framework, right, which is about diffusion of innovation theory. If I see anything that is related to this theoretical framework, I select and drop it into that respective container. So you can also bring your theoretical framework with the component here, and you can go through the data, identify information that are significant and drop it under the component, or you can develop codes. So it's all about just being flexible. At the end of the day, you want to show or find information that will help you to write about what is going on concerning your topic. So each topic, what you're going to do when you're writing your literature review is that you are going to compare and contrast concerning the topic about, let's say, a topic like promoting transparency. What are researchers saying about it? When you are writing about a topic, people want to know what are the articles saying about that topic. Are they related? Are they different? Why are they different? That's what you have to do. You are just like a reporter trying to help people to understand what you have done concerning a specific topic that you are focusing on. So imagine that you have gone through all the transcript, and then the next step that you have to think about is what kind of output can help me to present my findings. One of the output that could be helpful is when you go to explore metrics coding query. So you click on the plus sign, you go to select. This time you're going to select all the articles that you are interested in. So I select all of them, I click on OK. I go to the plus sign here, select items, and then I can go to codes, and then I would say, okay, for my research question one, I just want to see who said what, right? What articles are linked to these codes or themes? So I check that and I click on run query, and this will help you to know who is linked to these topics, right? You can see that for this topic, only the first participants are linked to that. For the second topic, only the first participant. This one is just a demonstration. Let's try another one. We want to bring a new set of codes. So we go to code, and then let's see the benefits. Select about the benefits. And then we click on OK, and then run query again. So this time it gives us information about the benefits, who are linked to that. So zero means that it's not linked to the article. One or above means that there's a link between the article and the topic. So that's how this one is going to help you when you are writing. Let's say you are writing about this topic. You can double click on that area where the number is and it will list what you coded so that it can give you an idea what you have to talk about when you are writing your literature review. Another thing that could be helpful is the framework metrics. How do you get a framework metrics? You can go to create framework metrics and then give it a name. So this time I'll just say testing, we are testing. And I go to roles, select. I can select all the cases that I want to see. Click on OK, and then I go to column, select, and this time I want to choose, let's say, ethical issues. So I check the topics under ethical issues. I click on OK, and then click on OK here. So what it will do is it will give you a spreadsheet that have all the articles and their respective themes, and then in the cells you have the information that was extracted. When you do this, it doesn't show everything, so you have to right click this place and go to undock so that it pulls up that information, the output for you, and then click on framework metrics and click on auto summarize. It will pull all the information that was extracted. So as you can see here, for this article nothing was extracted based on these topics. But for the second article, you can see that information were extracted based on these topics, right? So you can quickly, you can export this one and put in the Excel spreadsheet as you are writing about it. And you can see that If you are writing about concern about cheating, these are the articles that you can focus on, and then you can look at it and see, you can compare and contrast what you are saying. So this one is a very good tool to help you to effectively write your literature review. So I hope this one was helpful to you. There are many things that you could do. And if you have the skill of using this software, you can explore more and see what you're going to get and be able to write your literature review. But this one is the basic information if you want to start using NVivo to write your literature review. If you have any question, please feel free to contact me. I'll be happy to address them for you. You can also put your question in the comment section. I'll be happy to provide you the answers. So this is what I have for you. Before I go, I want to share with you our new book about dissertation. It's called Dissertation Research Methods. This one is very good. It gives you all the information that you need to write your dissertation. There's also a chapter about how to write your literature review. This one will be so helpful for you if you want to be able to complete your dissertation on time. You can get access to our book on Amazon. Thank you for your time.